The story of the American Sentinel starts with a very passionate individual, Lee Robinson, who was in veterinary medicine, and I think still is. He has a very good background in genetics and wanted to recreate the Swinford Bandog. So Swinford was one of the first to create a Bandog by combining Molosse, in this case English Mastiff blood with game bred Bull and Terrier blood, in this case American Pit Bull Terrier blood, if I'm not mistaken, or otherwise it was the Bull and Terrier that was later known as, for example, the American Pit Bull Terrier. And this Swinford band dog was very good. It was almost as good as a fighting dog. But of course, also fighting dogs, like in many fights, nice falconer, they have weight classes, so it was a lot bulkier, of course, because the Molosse blood, but an extremely good guardian. So in a band dog program, they want to keep the protective instinct and the laid-back personality of a Molosse and combine it with the fighting ethics, the endurance, the agility, the athleticism of a Bull and Terrier, a more combat type of dog, or dog-to-dog combat especially. And he started also with English Mastiff and American Pit Bull Terrier, and he took that for quite some time, and in my opinion he after a while got this breed more and more like big pit bulls, but big performance type of pit bulls. He had some very nice big American Pit Bull Terriers where he started out with, and after a while he found a line that really produced and clicked well with his Bandog program. And by selecting hard and also testing the dog's heart and choosing those that he wanted to continue with, he kept on doing his program and was very good at it, in my opinion. I think 15 or 16 years ago I once contacted Lee Robinson, because I myself was also interested in a bandog of this program, but there are some rules at the time that it was harder to get a dog without without a pedigree if it had certain looks. And as I mentioned, his type of band dogs had quite the looks of a big type of pit bull terrier. So of course the band dog often throws the side of the pit bull terrier, because it's a more, yeah, how to say this, I think it's a more favorable design than those very short-nosed or very bulky Molosse types. And he is still breeding them till this day, but the name changed from Swinford Bandog Recreation. I think his kennel name was Chimera Kennels. I thought also that this name was very nice. The Chimera is also a mix of two mythical creatures, so to say. And after a while he broadened it, and I think this is a very good choice, because by broadening your program and now naming it the American Sentinel, so sentinels also, yeah, those that guard the premises, guard the castles, guard the family of the king, princes and princesses, the queens of course, the royal family often. And this is what this type of dog was bred to do. So it's a modern interpretation and also modern functionality of your elite guardian. And by broadening the base, by calling it American Sentinel, and also working together with other groups that are in protection work and also in band dog programs, he has created more structure and more a broader foundation, so to say, for its breed. So that way you can also have more dogs in your program and select the better ones to continue with. And also the gene pool is much wider. And also another factor is that most of his customers were quite delighted with the products he produced, and of course some can be better than the others, which is in any breeding program so. But Lee strives to produce very good band dogs, and he has a driven family that supports him and works with him, which is nice. And he also selects the best dogs he can get his hands on, which is the best way to approach such a project, of course. Well, I hope you also like this small tribute, and I really hope that it develops into even better dogs.